Hello there. My name is Alyssa. Sorry, I didn't know we were on the air. Welcome to the Bookshelf. Today, I will be speaking to you about Linda Gray Sexton, the author of Half in Love and Bespotted, along with many other books. Linda Sexton was born July 21st, 1953, and is still alive to this day. She grew up in Newton, Massachusetts, fairly close to us, and she has written many memoirs, several novels, and even edited her mother's work. Linda's mother, Anne Sexton, suffered from depression and suicidal thoughts all throughout Linda's life, and ended up killing herself when Linda was only 21. She locked herself in a car and closed the garage, so her mother died of carbon monoxide poisoning. Anne Sexton was also a well-known author and poet, winning many awards, including the Pulitzer Prize. Linda Sexton's writing, especially Half in Love, is often influenced by experience with her mother's suicide attempts and her father often leaving because of this. And she also writes a lot about the fights between her mother and father and the impact that that has. Stay tuned. Bookshelf will return after this commercial.
Where is Balake at? No Balake here today. Yes, sir.
My name is Blake.
Are you out of your goddamn mind?
Blake?
What? Do you want to go to war, Balaki? Because we could go to war.
No.
I'm for real.
Welcome back. Now we're going to get into one of Linda Sexton's fabulous books. The first one I read was Half in Love. This was an amazing memoir all about Linda Sexton's life and the impact that suicide and depression has on her, not just including her mother's legacy of suicide, but what happened to Linda throughout her life. It was amazing to understand what Linda was going through. At one point, she was describing how, although she knew what her family members would feel if she committed suicide, she still tried to commit suicide 3 times, which to most of us is a crazy idea. And you're like, how would someone do that to their family? But you have no idea. And after reading Half in Love, I have so much more understanding for people that suffer from suicidal thoughts. So the next book that I read after Half in Love was Bespotted, which I was expecting to be a little bit more positive, upbeat, maybe some puppy love, you know, gotta love the puppies. And it ended up being like what I expected, but then also still including some of the suicidal thoughts in the way that her dogs and her, especially her Dalmatians, helped her get through those rough times. And it just goes to show what the impact that animals can have in your life. So from both of the memoirs, Half in Love and Bespotted, I fell in love with Linda Sexton. Her writing style is so cool because unlike her mother, Anne Sexton, she writes in a way that doesn't just speak to the depression, but also engages the readers and gets them to actually understand what she's talking about. And instead of just laying out all of her feelings, she connects with the readers and she somehow, I can't even explain it right. Okay, now that I've kind of re-pulled the book off the shelf, I can explain it a little bit better. So basically what Linda Sexton does is she has these descriptions for her readers that just, okay, I'm speechless. Again. So through reading Bespotted and Half in Love, I can understand not that just Linda Sexton is a great writer because she grew up with her mother, Anne Sexton, who was also a great writer, but she understands how to describe her feelings and not just write them down on paper like, I am sad. It's, I am sad as a waterfall, and it like just this huge description, and you're like, what? And she's just honestly amazing. I am so glad I picked her. I literally fell in love with this author. It's amazing the detail that she can go into and the way that she connects with her readers. Okay, so Linda Sexton is not Anne Lamott, but her writing style, or the way that she writes, also includes a little bit of how her mother influenced her writing and how she became a writer as a child, writing down her thoughts, and when she was feeling depressed, she would write down stuff, and that's just how she got through it, and that's great, but it also helped her become a better writer. So it's not Anne Lamott style bird by bird, but it is also a little bit of how she became a writer, which is kind of a cool perspective to see. Like any bookshelf episode, we always end it with a punny quote. So this one today is number 8 on punoftheday.com. And it's, I read a book about gravity. It was a heavy subject. And I think this really relates to what Linda Sexton's writing style was, because it was a heavy subject that she wrote about, but she found a way to make it enjoyable and relatable for readers, which I thought was very amazing, and I would 9 out of 10 suggest Linda Sexton. The 1 out of 10 is just because on a sad day, you may not want to read it, but it could help you get through it, so 10 out of 10, read it.
Gotta keep reading, 'cause this book's gonna be a good book. 'Cause this book's gonna be a good book. 'Cause this book's gonna be a good, good book to read. 'Cause this book's gonna be a good, good book to read.